One time, when Sister Teresa read a eulogy written by me after our common friend passed away, she said, "When I die, I would like you to write about me in such a beautiful way as well." I will try. On November 15, in Poznań, Pokrzywno, Poland, after 73 years of vocation, Sister Teresa Bartnicka passed away. Born in Gdynia, a small fishing village, transforming at that time into first sea port of Poland, she came from an average family. Nevertheless, the family touching or even writing a history. Her aunt fought for Polish independence, organized women auxiliary forces in pre-war Poland, fought in Warsaw Uprising of 1944. Persecuted by Stalin regime, became the first woman in Polish history nominated to Brigadier General of Polish Army. By the way, Sister Teresa died almost at the same age as her aunt. Her family, during October Revolution, moved to Kiev, Ukraine. Her mother was looking for a job. One day she saw an ad searching very qualified secretary. The mother went for interview, and she was interviewed by a quiet man. Despite having all necessary qualifications, job was denied. Man said, "It's a pity, but I cannot hire you. I cannot allow you to have this job." Teresa's mother left, of course, crying. After years, she learned that that man looking for a secretary was Felix Dzierżyński, nickname Iron Felix, Polish origin Bolshevik, the head of Soviet secret police, and the key architect of the Red Terror, sending millions of citizens to death. Sister Teresa commented, "Perhaps that day, seeing young Polish beautiful woman, he had a human feeling, and he didn't want her to be a witness to atrocities and cruelty." After first year of law university, by the way, Sister Teresa had a degree in classical philology, she joined the Ursulines of the Roman Union. She quickly climbed the ladder of a monastic career. For 12 years she was an assistant general. But before, she taught Latin in Ursulinian school in Gdynia, and she was a boarding school superior. This memory is the memory of her students from Gdynia. Superiors sent Sister Teresa to Gdynia because no one was able to deal with Gdynia's students, who used all their energy and invention to create constant situation that led Ursulines to have heart attack. For first month, Sister Teresa was stunned by our activity, and sometimes even crying. When she decided that enough is enough, we were stunned by her actions. We, her Gdynia students, ourselves are almost reaching the end of our journey. We have our life, families, problems, and we did not, with a few exceptions, kept constant contact with Sister Teresa. However, nobody forget Sister Teresa, and we always remember years spent together. She was our mentor, teaching life thinking, manners, discipline. She was also fair and warm. She was sometimes bossy, even overreacting. She forbade us from doing a fashionable at that time haircut. So we convinced one of our friends to go to the hairdresser, and she did it anyway. When we came back, Sister Teresa without a word, pulled our colleague into a cold shower. Another day, she took 2 7-year-old girls to public school. Suddenly, one took off. Sister Teresa chased her, caught, and returned to another kid. The child waited politely because before she got a good slap with the command not to move. Myself, I was hit on the head with the spine of a book in presence of mother superior, school director, and school board inspectors, because in my stupidity, I played a prank in the situation when all religious schools in Poland were placed under surveillance. But at the same time, from the moment when Sister Teresa became our teacher and mentor, everybody treated school and boarding school as the home. Sister Teresa took care of us in sickness, although her main remedy, hot wine with eggs, yolks, was horrible. She allowed us to go to movie theaters, opera. Every Sunday, we walked 10 kilometers along Baltic Sea shore. Every Friday, we had our own fireplace. We put wooden logs on the floor, small lamp on logs, and all was covered with transparent red paper, and we sang camping songs. Every time during excursions, Sister Teresa bought us ice cream or chocolate, and every time when she went out, she took someone with her as a companion, a significant dent in very strict discipline protocol. We were, of course, very happy. One day, she returned with 12 cakes. According to her and our colleagues' relation, on her way back home, she spotted her brother, the maritime captain, who all the boarding girls were in love with. This big man was leaving a small pastry shop and on hand as big as a loaf of bread, held a package. "What is it?" asked Sister Teresa. "Cakes," the brother answered. "Good, thanks." And she grabbed the package and left. Stunned brother stood a while, then returned to pastry shop. After told his mother, "I bought 24 cakes. Mother scolded him before he delivered explanation that 12 cakes were stolen by her own daughter. So our life was passing by, and contacts of many of us with Sister Teresa were very limited, especially when Sister Teresa went to Rome. Only myself, living in Canada, was able to meet her in different places of the globe. However, I was always acting as a liaison between Sister Teresa and her students, my colleagues, and I always was amazed how many talents, abilities, and achievements were not recognized by us in the past. She was a hard worker with determination, always ready to learn and achieve. She was used to no opposition, so often imposed her opinion. But even if someone not really follow her guidance, her comments, her advice were always helping us to solve our problems. Sister Teresa was one of the most bright persons I ever met, always seeing through and always going straight to the point. She was a warm, loving people person and treasuring people's love, but she made a great mistake. She thought that showing such feelings, she shows the weakness. And she was smiling, joking, taking care of others. However, she surrounds herself with a wall. She was always at distance under self-control. Who knows, perhaps that's what led to the later health problem, strokes. when she started to show her own personality as a loving people person, and someone needed people's kindness so much, she already started to immerse into a different world. She was happy, smiling, easygoing. However, more and more moving away from reality. For example, she often told Ursuline nuns, sister, I remember you, but what is your name? I had the privilege as one of the few to be in her heart and to be recognized for a long time. But one time, all ended. And her earth journey is ended as well. We all shall remember Sister Teresa, despite her last stages of life not really favorable to her. We will remember her as the proud, bright, full of life, love and joy woman, a beautiful woman. We were proud when people stood suddenly on their way seeing Sister Teresa's beauty. How often we annoyed her, shouting, sister, this man cannot take his eye off you. One time one of us found the courage and asked, why you joined the convent? With such beauty you can have a wonderful family. Sister Teresa looked at her reproachfully and said, what do you think? The God needs only corset?